Ladies and gentlemen, please be upstanding to welcome the procession of the Lord Lieutenant of Leicestershire, members of the Board of Governors and Academic Board, the Dean of the Faculty of Arts, Design and Humanities, the Pro-Chancellor and the Deputy Vice-Chancellor of De Montfort University. Please remain standing for the national anthem performed by a representative of the De Montfort University Chamber Choir. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Pro-Chancellor of De Montfort University, Professor David Wilson.
Please be seated. Lord Lieutenant of Leicestershire, honoured guests, members of the Board of Governors and Academic Board, ladies and gentlemen, graduands, welcome to De Montfort University. Today we offer congratulations to all graduating students from the Faculty of Arts, Design and Humanities as we confer their degrees and diplomas. To those graduating today, savour this moment and savour your success. Remember, your DMU days do not end here. In crossing the stage today, you join a network of DMU graduates living and working across the world, and you remain part of our university family as our alumni. You will be our eyes, ears, and hands, our ambassadors. It is a very special responsibility, and it is something else that we hand to you today, along with your certificate. And so, enjoy today, enjoy this ceremony. Thank you, and sincere congratulations.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Deputy Vice-Chancellor of De Montfort University, Professor Andy Collop.
Pro-Chancellor, members of the Board of Governors, honoured guests and graduands, and let me start by saying that I'm very proud to be here with you today to celebrate your success at De Montfort University. Now, I want to start my speech by asking you a question. Should you do the easy thing or the right thing? And to help you answer, I want to tell you about DMU's links with a place more than 4,000 miles away. In the 1960s, students from this institution gave their time to teach children who just arrived in Leicester from India. They helped them to speak English, settle into education, and integrate into city life. So DMU's commitment to the public good isn't a new phenomenon. The university has a proud history of reaching out and working with communities to tackle challenges together, and this tradition still flourishes today. Square Mile and DMU Local, initiatives that harness the volunteering power of our students and staff, now work with Leicester communities speaking more than 60 languages across the city and beyond. Our partnership with Leicester City Council and the City Mayor Sir Peter Salisbury is now one of the strongest and most ambitious in the country. It spans the key areas of education, health, and regeneration across 126 projects involving nearly 3,000 students who to date have volunteered for 33,000 hours of work. Leicester is enriched by one of the largest Indian heritage populations beyond the subcontinent, many of whom study and work here at DMU, and of this we're extremely proud. So 2 years ago, it seemed natural to extend and strengthen this connection through perhaps our most ambitious international project yet, DMU Square Mile India. Like the Square Mile project we created in Leicester, the idea was simple. Take the energy, skills and experience we have on campus and the human and intellectual capital of our students and staff and use this to deliver positive change in the community. Only this community would be in the Gujarat. Through Square Mile India, hundreds of staff and students have been able to directly support children of the lowest Indian caste, the Dalits, also known as the Untouchables, living in a hostel on the site of the Gandhi Ashram in Ahmedabad. A specially devised program of learning activities, sport, health outreach and research is also benefiting those living in the adjacent slum, Ramipir Notekro. Currently, on average, at least one group of students flies out every month to work on this project via DMU's International Student Mobility Programme, DMU Global. So, for example, students from nursing and midwifery have travelled to Ahmedabad to put their skills into practice, training more than 300 health workers, volunteers and preschool teachers in areas such as basic first aid, mental health awareness and learning disability advice. Students from audiology have tested the hearing of more than 350 people, resulting in 150 hearing aids being fitted and the treatment of ear infections to prevent future hearing loss. Our Centre for English Language Learning has trained 22 English teachers in new techniques, and dance, drama and performing arts students have led classes with more than 900 people, providing a much needed break from their often harsh daily lives. This work not only makes a significant difference to others, but almost as importantly, is deeply rewarding to those who volunteer their skills. So today, I want to extend an invitation to you, our soon-to-be alumni, to be a continuing part of this extraordinary project as it expands into the future. Let me explain in this video.
So in 2013, I came to this building behind me, which is the Gandhi Ashram, which is where Mahatma Gandhi lived between 1918 and 1930. And I had the great honour of being awarded the Gandhi Seva Medal here in 2013 because of the Square Mile Project, which DMU set up with our local community back in Leicester. And after I arrived here, I realised that there was so much that we could actually export to India. We could actually create a Square Mile India.
The Vice Chancellor of DMU University happens to be here in Gandhi Ashram for a beautiful small event. And in a very organic way, he strolled around into the ashram, into where our kids were laughing and dancing and having a good time. And that caught him. That caught his attention. And he stopped and started having a dialogue with the kids and wanted to find out who these kids are. And then from there, the seed was planted in his heart to do something.
So since we founded Square Mile India, we've undertaken 28 different trips, and we've blended those into the DMU Global Program, where we offer every student at DMU the opportunity to spend some time during their career at DMU overseas. We're installing solar panels in rural India. We built a very large number of washrooms, which is a crucial part of Prime Minister Modi's drive to improve sanitation. So our main partner in India is called Manav Sadhana. They're an educational charity who run 5 community centres here in Ahmedabad. And I progressively, over the last 2 or 3 years, visited all of those community centres apart from one. And the final one was called the Loving Community. And I never really understood until very recently why there was a reluctance for me to go and visit. And essentially, it's because the Loving Community is focused on what used to be formerly known as a leper colony. And when I arrived there, it was quite clear that there was a very significant need for the community, which is around their living accommodation. So I came back and I spoke to our head of our School of Architecture, Simon Bradbury, and he immediately, within 2 weeks of me having this conversation, had got on a plane and gone out to the Loving Community to do an analysis of what we might be able to offer these people.
We're here at the Loving Community, where a number of the residents here have suffered from leprosy. And in addition to that, every monsoon season, there's a huge amount of water that inundates the village. And that water overflows the sewage system, contaminating that water and flooding the houses up to about a metre. So in the first instance, the immediate need is to raise some of the properties out of the flood water. And working with an architect and on Senecia here, our students came out and participated in some early design solutions working alongside those residents that look not only at raising their homes, but how those homes would be fit for their future life and enable expansion and extension. So the students that have undertaken this work, which we're looking to embed within one of the modules that they'll be doing, so all students have the opportunity to participate, will enable them obviously to understand basic construction elements and the kind of technology of construction. But as important as that is to understand the meaning and the kind of social context of the work they're doing and how important it is as an architect to really kind of serve the needs of users across a wide range of issues.
So the word unique is somewhat overused nowadays, but Square Mile India truly is a unique initiative. Where else could you go to a university, study a discipline, be prepared for your employability by going overseas, putting into practice your values, your commitment to the public good, and actually making a difference to so many people's lives? You change their lives for the better, but your life forever.
So, the easy thing or the right thing? Well, this project certainly isn't easy. As you saw in the film, the environment is harsh, occasionally hostile, and during much of the year, extremely hot and polluted. The Loving Community is also dealing with one of the world's most stigmatized diseases, leprosy. Ancient taboos mean that entire families are deprived of job opportunities, education, and their future. This project and the way its many facets work together highlight a large number of your university strengths. Real-world, gold-standard teaching, framing academic expertise and knowledge. Excellent life-changing research that informs our curriculum. Our commitment to internationalisation and a global perspective in all that we do, exemplified through DMU Global. Our determination to be a force for public good, whether that be on our doorstep or thousands of miles away. Gandhi's principles of tolerance, acceptance, and a refusal to accept discrimination in any form, and our unshakable belief in what is right. In January, we held a conference at the headquarters of the United Nations in New York, with a global network of universities working together to share ideas and collaborate to support refugees and migrants. For a long time now, DMU has engaged with Leicester's refugee community, offering IT classes, language skills, and career support. And it was because of our experience in this area that the UN invited us to engage in this work and use our social media expertise to amplify its impact. It was truly an amazing and unforgettable day. DMU was at the heart of the United Nations, at the centre of international diplomacy and global cooperation. Our students, as activist diplomats, were in the thick of the debate, advancing a cause that goes to the very heart of our work as a civic and global university. And last month, we led another event to the UN with hundreds of our final year students, at which we committed to broaden our campaign to embrace all the UN's 17 Sustainable Development Goals. These goals, launched in 2016, are a blueprint for positive global change. They set clear targets to tackle poverty and hunger and promote sustainable growth, health care and education, among other important issues. Together, they represent a manifesto for the world and a roadmap towards a fairer and more sustainable planet. Such is their importance that this week we launched our new strategic plan, committing to embed these goals within all our operations. And we launched this plan in the presence of Mahe Nasa, the director of the UN's Public Outreach Programme. This isn't necessarily going to be easy, but who can doubt that it's the right thing for us to do? This September, we will ban the use of non-recyclable plastic on campus in support of Sustainable Development Goal 14, which looks to preserve life underwater. Few are now unaware of the appalling impact that society's unrestricted use of plastic is having on our oceans. It was feedback from many of you that made us determined to act. Alongside the ban, we're also issuing more than 26,000 free reusable coffee cups to all students and staff. This decision is just the start of a programme of specific but important and far-reaching activities in support of the UN goals. This is our vision for DMU. But making this happen is about individuals standing up, taking part, and making a difference. This is the DMU way, the power of the small action, the selfless action, and the right action. Many of you, our graduands, exemplify these qualities, and I take inspiration from all of you. In graduating today, each of you has demonstrated your own strength and determination in gaining a university qualification. Be very proud of yourselves. This is a tremendous accomplishment. I encourage all of you to continue your journey, and as you do so, to opt to do the right thing. You won't be alone. You'll have each other, your friends and family, and you will have us. You are now each a vital addition to DMU's 175,000 strong, supportive, influential and global alumni network. We call it DMU for life, and it is, I'm afraid, a life sentence. And I'm pleased to announce today a range of new benefits that will be available through DMU for life. As DMU alumni, you can still be part of DMU Global and its world of possibilities, and part of DMU Local, its volunteering, its activism, and the chance it provides to make a difference to others. You can continue to shape and direct your career and ambitions through DMU works placements and employer opportunities. You can continue to access our library, educational materials and support. You can remain part of our sporting circle and members of the leisure centre, and you can keep in touch, easily and for life, with everyone who has helped to shape your best memories. Sadly, as we now know, football's definitely not coming home, but at least you'll be coming home when we invite you back the class of 2018 for DMU's first ever alumni homecoming event, and we'll be in touch with more details in the autumn. The degree you've earned represents many years of planning, sacrifice, and investment. Your investment in your future is a belief in the future, a belief in yourself as a citizen of the world, and a belief that you can be the change you want to see every day. A belief that you can do the right thing. Not the easy thing, not the obvious thing, not the popular thing, not the safe thing, but the right thing. For you, for others, for the planet, and for life. Thank you very much, and many congratulations.
Ladies, gentlemen, and graduates, we now show a film celebrating the ongoing contribution of the faculty to our students graduating today through DMU for Life.
University was a really important part of my life because I wouldn't be stood where I am in front of this beautiful theatre and having the career that I currently have. It gave me a great pathway and it gave me great experiences and it gave me great knowledge and ownership of my own destiny, really.
The biggest thing that I've actually gained from coming to DMU has just been letting myself be more creative in terms of chasing what I actually want to do.
I knew as soon as I stepped out of the car on my first day here that this was going to be the best 3 years ever.
Leicester is a really diverse city. The theatre industry here is amazing.
My name is Jude and my job is Vice President of Accessories for Coach in New York. I wouldn't have been able to be in this industry without the experience I had at De Montfort University.
Things I found out about when I was at DMU was the camaraderie and sharing ideas and cross-fertilisation, and I've really taken that with me when I collaborate with other artists. It's something that I love doing.
My name's Jessica Dawson and I'm the design team manager here at Clover. All the lecturers were amazing, they really supported us, showed us how to do technical, design, everything. They were brilliant.
In Barcelona we went to a few art and design museums, were encouraged to sketch, and that's a skill that we brought back here to university.
We went to Naples this year. I found that really, really interesting. It was so nice to see that part of Italy. I based my final third year project on one of the sites that we visited during the trip. It's been really interesting and challenging.
The biggest piece of advice that I could give is to make the most of every opportunity available. There are so many fantastic schemes like DMU Local, DMU Global, and now obviously DMU for Life. You know, make yourself a part of it. Make the most of every opportunity that there is to offer, because actually that will enhance your employability.
Getting involved in student groups and making a lot of good network connections that allow me to have a better hope in the future of getting work.
Since working in theatre and overseeing the partnership with DMU for Curve, I do know how important those opportunities are. This is an extremely difficult industry to work in, and the people that are considered are the people who have the experience like DMU offer.
I'm Andrew. I'm currently working in Hong Kong. Been here for the last 7 years. Employers are looking for certain things in people when they come through, so they don't just get caught down this road of getting your coursework done, learn those soft skills that are required to get into the industry.
DMU for Life will allow past students to go on other future DMU global trips.
I've been to Paris and New York, so hopefully maybe I'll get to go to Berlin or even further to India.
I think it's really important for alumni to stay in touch with DMU, especially based on the great experience I had of studying there.
I'm looking forward to coming and visiting, talking to the current students, inspiring them, telling them about my experience as an artist and what it's like to survive as an artist.
If myself or other alumni can help current students, then I think it's really important.
Life for me in Hong Kong is brilliant. It's always living in the fast lane. Networking is the key thing. If you go on an internship, keep in contact with those people.
Career opportunities that you might get in contact with someone else who's an alumni and has been in the university to help you like further your career along.
We hope you to come back to the university, especially to take part in some guest lectures that we have here that the school organises.
Your connection with the university gets stronger as you get older, because I think you begin to appreciate the grounding and the foundation that the university can actually provide you.
I wish I could do it all over again, but the exact same way, because it was just such a joyful time of my life and one that I'll treasure forever.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the De Montfort University Gospel Choir.
promise we'll take the world to its feet and move mountains to get to its feet and move
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Deputy Vice-Chancellor, Professor Andy Collop, for the conferment of the awards to graduates and diplomates from the Faculty of Arts, Design and Humanities.
Members of the Faculty of Arts, Design and Humanities, by the powers vested in me by the Board of Governors and the Academic Board, I confer on you the awards to which you are entitled. Please commence the presentation of graduands and diplomates to the Pro-Chancellor. And members of the audience, friends, family, supporters, as our students graduate and walk through the centre of the stage, please make as much noise and support our students as best you can. Thank you.
Honourable Pro-Chancellor, I present to you the graduands and diplomates of the Faculty of Arts, Design and Humanities, who, by their achievement, have had conferred on them academic awards of the university. The School of Humanities, the degree of Bachelor of Arts in Creative Writing and Drama Studies, Kirsten Amber Donovan. Rory Daniel Gillen. Shannon Webb. Jack Wilkin. In creative writing and English, Lydia Bell. Hannah Brown. Andre Anthony Chance Cohen. Jones. Winner of the final year with languages student, Adil Lakhani. Nicole London. Sarah Quinton. In creative writing and English language, Lorna Ball. Kina Broadhead. Winner of the Creative Writing Portfolio Prize, Jennifer Ruby Brooks. Luke Clark. Kayla Ashley Dutton. Harry Emson. Jordan Shepherd. Georgia Varney. Alicia Valenciak. Christian Walsh. In creative writing and film studies, Catherine Mary Adderley. Faith Elizabeth Bennett. Alicia Hamill. Haley Vithian. Samuel Walsfold. In creative writing with English language, Vern Hayden Withers. In English, Ayan Abdi. Zainab Ayoub. Rebecca Stephanie Aziz. Amber Rose Bailey. Jennifer Conway. Emily Margaret Irene Kura. Winner of the Nicholas Zurbrugger Dissertation Prize, winner of the final year with languages student, winner of the best essay in adaptations or textual studies, Lily Paulina Devereaux. Annabelle Dixon. Haley Fieldsend. Samuel Foley. Hannah Madeline Fowler. Phoebe Galbraith. Isabella Jude Hayes. Faris Hussein. Samuel Edwin James. Holly Jones. Hannah Lewis. Winner of the final year with languages student, Lois Elsa Linkins. Rory McDermott. Ella Louise McGill. Madia Mohammed. Jack Murphy. Victoria Elizabeth Pass. Oliver Plum. Shannon Elizabeth Marie Reynolds. Phoebe Sharp. Safa Siddiqui. Holly Tebbutt. Winner of the final year with languages student, Paige Temple. Jessica Thacker. Phoebe Hannah Tilly. Sean Yates Smith. Samantha Yin Sam Yao. Faisal Yusuf. In English and English language, Yasmin Akhtar. Arif Islam. Laura Michelle Doreen Amy Jones. Mohammed. Bethany Neelands. In English and Film Studies, Anika Hussein. In English and History, Umar Taylor.
Renuka Varma. In English and media, Grace Emma Deacon. Alice Goodwin. Shahista Sakrani. In English language and media, Oliver Dennis. Todd Groom. Masuma Mirza. Katie Elizabeth Shannon. Pavanjeet Verdi. In English language with creative writing, Aisha Khan. Yuditha Shastuketa. In English language with English literature, Alicia Bakhtar. Winner of the final year with languages student, Laura Marie Collingnan. Amy Dransfield. Samira Khan. Winner of the English Language Dissertation Prize, Denisha Polin. Hannah Stimpson. In History, Louise Francis Bailey. Vladimir Bezhik. Joseph Byrne. Shika Chopra. Winner of the Glenford Marlon Xavier Prize, winner of the final year history student, winner of the Gert Hinrich Ahrens Prize, Jessica Kate Kretney. Ryan Ellicott. Samuel Frank Haywood Eyre. Luke Gallagher. Chloe Louise Glover. Ben Gull. Alice Ann Harvey. Kieran Howard. J. James Mannell. Samuel MacDonald. Joseph Mee. Aisha Zuleika Mohammed. Orlana Isabel Morris. Winner of the final year with languages student, Stephanie Lauren Morton. Hina Hitan Pandit. Henry Pugh. Ryan Sherwood. Sarah Snowden. William Webb. Jordan White. Chloe Whitehead. Andrew Yates. Yonis Yusuf. In History and International Relations, Joe Longuhay. In History and Politics, Emily Barnes. Julia Drogoš. James Everard. Kate Mansfield. David Milnes. Shannon Wilson. In Sports History and Culture, Kasha Raja. The degree of Master of Arts in Humanities, Victoria Lawrence. Thank you. Taylor Ann Vaughan. The degree of Doctor of Philosophy in English Literature, Laura Jane Devaney. Maya Koranahoka. Richard Razvan Omrod Vidnyoko. The Faculty of University Wide Learning, the Foundation Degree in Arts, in Artistic Makeup and Special Effects, Samantha Cheung. Brittany Marriott. Yay! Holly Ann Tompkins. Mahek Fatima JD. In tourism, hospitality and events management, Ria J. Ambasna. Natasha Green. Shimona Rayarel. The degree of Bachelor of Arts in Performing Arts, Professional Studies, Macaulay Brazil. Sarbjit Tommy Singh. Jessica Taylor. In Professional Studies, Creative Industries, Hiral Badrakia. Charlotte Bancroft. Claire Cooper. Ashley Gettings. Lewis Hunt. Viveki Jamnadis. Pamela Kumwenda. Virginia Morrow. Brogan Morris. Zainab Patel. Daniel Skinder. The degree of Bachelor of Science in Construction Management, Rafiq Hussein. Alan Lokes. Rhys Robinson. David Lloyd Smith. Nathan Taylor. The foundation degree in arts, in tourism, hospitality, and events management. Monica Navotemo. Mohit Movadia. This concludes the presentation of graduates and diplomates of the Faculty of Arts, Design and Humanities. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Deputy Vice-Chancellor, Professor Andy Collop, to close the ceremony.
honoured guests, members of the Board of Governors and the Academic Board, ladies and gentlemen, and of course, I can now importantly say, graduates. My last formal duty is to bring this ceremony to a close. But remember, nothing ends today. Today is about the future. Leave this stage and this hall with every confidence. The future is yours. We're very proud of each and every one of you. Thank you very much and very many congratulations.